I got a phone call in my kitchen one day. I don't normally answer the phone, but this time I did, and the voice said, "Ciao, this is Luciano Pavarotti," and I looked at him. "Really?" I said, "Well, I'm Sting." He said, "Yes, I know." He said, "I want you to sing with me." I said, "Really?" So I was in the kitchen, all the kids and Trudy, and I said, "Well, what do you want me to sing?" He said, "Oh, it's an old Latin hymn called Panis Angelicus, Bread of Heaven or something." I said, "Well, I don't know it." And then he said, "Well, I'll sing it to you." So he started to sing Panis in this incredible tenor voice. And so I immediately put the speakerphone on, and all the kids were going, "Wow, it's Pavarotti." He took me water skiing once in his boat, and it was a very rough day. And I'm not a bad water skier, but there were high waves. But he was so busy talking to Trudy that he totally ignored the fact that he'd left me about a mile behind, ditched me. Trudy didn't notice either, of course, but they eventually came back for me and saved me.
Your Royal Highness, Nicoletta, Alice, beloved friends, good evening. It's amazing to be here with you all to honor our dear friend Luciano. The significance of our short lives, as we see in front of us this 2,000-year-old civilization hewn from these 60 million year old rocks, our lives are indeed short. But our lives are measured by how we are seen, how we are heard, how we are therefore viewed. Of all the places in the world, this spectacular setting befits our memories of Luciano in its scale, in its beauty, and in its uniqueness. There was only one Luciano Pavarotti. His passing has left an immense gulf in all of our lives. But I feel sure that this gathering tonight, by us sharing our personal stories of Luciano, we will bring him close to us once more, and I have a certain sense that Luciano would have given his most ravishing smile at the sight of us all here. Sing.
I have to confess that I'd never seen an opera before Luciano Pavarotti invited Trudy and myself to see him perform in one of his finest roles in Tosca at the Royal Opera House. And we watched the performance. And then at the end of the performance, we went backstage to give him our congratulations, along with all of his other friends. And Luciano was sitting there in full costume, full makeup, and full wig. And he said, "Ah, Sting and Trudy, I will meet you later at the restaurant at the Hyde Park Hotel. There's a table. I'll meet you later, okay?" I said, "Thank you, Luciano." And I said, "Trudy, you know, he's going to be a long time because he has to take his costume off, have a shower, makeup off, wig, get dressed. It's going to take about an hour and a half." So we get to the restaurant, and it's a full restaurant, and we're sitting down. I'm saying, you know, it's going to be a long wait, when suddenly there's a noise, and at the door, in full makeup, full costume, and full wig, is Luciano Pavarotti. Everyone in the restaurant stands up. He gets the second standing ovation of the night, and I said, "That is a star. That is truly a star."
Well, I'd like to make a personal observation, if I may. Being the wife of a famous musician, one notices that in certain circles you can be very well attended to when the famous husband is around and not quite so noticed when he's not. But with Luciano, it was never like that. If I was ever in New York without Sting, if Sting was on tour, I would get the phone call, and Nico and Luciano would invite me and the kids, who were very young at that time, to come around and have a great dinner with them. I'll always treasure those personal memories of him as a family man. He was so caring and so gracious to me. He was a very dear and true friend.
I have one more story. The first time Luciano visited us in our home in England, he was coming up the stairs and I opened the big double doors for such a big man. And he said, "Ah, Sting, you make a joke about my weight." I said, "No, Luciano." He said, "You see, today I'm on a diet." I said, "Okay." So we went down to dinner. And Luciano's idea of a diet was a strange one. Luciano ate 2 entire chickens. He had a big appetite, this man. He had a big appetite for everything. He had an appetite for life. But it was matched by a huge generosity of spirit. Luciano was a big man. He had a big heart. And that generosity was transformed into his voice. And when we heard his voice, all of us were richer. And thank you, Luciano. I'm proud to have known you. I'm proud to have been your friend. I'm proud to have sang with you. And I'm proud to have sat down to dinner with you and given you 2 chickens. Thank you, Luciano.
Have you seen by the bright lily grow? Before rude hands have touched it, have you marked the fall of the snow? Before the earth had smudged it, have you felt the love weaver or someone's down the I've smelt of the bud of the briar or the nod in the fog, or I've tasted the bag of the bee, oh so white, oh so soft, oh so sweet is she. So sweet.